Hey YouTube, how you doing? This is your girl Tasha, just coming to you with another review for Fantasia For Real, episode 7, season 2. Let's get into it.
She had been to a place called hell on earth when your body's the same.
Okay, I'm kind of at a loss for words, so I don't know how good this review is going to be, because I really don't want to review it. Not that, you know, I don't want to give you guys a video or anything, but I really want you guys to watch this episode. If you don't watch Fantasia For Real and you only watch the reviews that, you know, people do on YouTube, you really need to at least check out this episode and maybe the one before, just so you can get some background or whatnot. But episode 7, you really need to watch that. First of all, I just want to say thank you to VH1, the producers, Fantasia, for doing this episode, you know, and just being really real about it. Like, they put Fantasia For Real. That title is very well lived up to, probably even beyond some, regarding this episode. What I really like about it is they started off the show with just the producer in the background. You can hear them. You know, they're getting ready to do the commentary shots for the episode. But before they even get into that, the producer says, hey, we're just going to let you sit and talk and say what's on your heart. Basically, that's what he says. So Fantasia starts talking about what happened after she left the lawyer's office. And you guys, I knew that I needed to prepare myself, so I had put my emotional walls up already. Because Fantasia, you weren't going to have me crying, girl, because I was going to go there. You know, you weren't going to have me sitting at home crying. But I did good. I was shocked mostly. I don't know why I was shocked, because, you know, we heard about this already, you know, the media reports or whatnot, and then we saw her on GMA, and we watched the behind the music, so we kind of knew what was going on, what was being said and stuff. But I was still in shock watching, you know, Fantasia talk about what happened after she left the lawyer's office. And I don't want to really get into all that, because I really want you guys to go and watch this episode. It's definitely going to rerun on VH1, so check your local listings and get into it. It's not online yet. I think it'll be online tomorrow, but already you can watch highlights, which pretty much gives you the whole episode. You can watch the highlights and you can watch bonus clips, which is really good, on fantasia.vh1.com. So you guys go there, fantasia.vh1.com, watch the bonus clips and the highlights, and you can pretty much, you know, capture the essence of this episode. It was really good. It was really humbling, I guess, to watch, you know, Fantasia go through. Because, okay, listen, we always hear, you know, celebrities say just because you have money and fame and all this stuff, you know, you can still be lonely, and, you know, money doesn't always bring you happiness, type kind of stuff. I feel that throughout her whole entire career, Fantasia has maintained her personal exterior to herself, where, you know, she's just an around the way chick. You know, you can walk up to them and be like, yo, what's going on? Some other celebrities, you can't really do that with, you know. And I feel that there's this distance, you know, celebrity fan type kind of thing. But I feel like the playing fields are kind of level when it comes to Fantasia. So for her to sit there and talk, and she's talking about, you know, what she was thinking about, what drove her to actually taking the pills. And to me, I don't think it started off as a suicide type kind of thing. Even though she was saying stuff like, you know, I just wanted it to be over with. I wanted to escape. I wanted to get out of this situation. She talks about how, you know, she decided to take some sleeping pills because she was talking about, you know, the media just ran with it, you know, and really made her look really, really, really bad. She felt that her fans, you know, which was kind of weird, because if you watch one of the bonus clips, she talks about how she feels like her fans had betrayed her. You know what I'm saying? She felt like a lot of her fans had turned their backs on her, because all we listened to was what the media has said and made our judgments about her. And Fantasia, girl, we did not. You know, I think about what I had said and how I was feeling about the whole thing. I didn't know if it was true or not, but then when I saw the pictures, I was like, this girl, she know better than that. She know better than that. Let's see. I didn't turn my back on Fantasia. I didn't. you know, if anything, I prayed for her more. And I do remember, I don't know which video I said it in, but I did say that this is a consequence because I felt that Fantasia had stepped out of the will of God, you know, and this is a consequence. Well, this is what you're going to have to go through if you want to live your life the way you want to live it. But if you don't want to live your life for Christ and do what he said and let his will, you know, lead your life, then this is what you're going to have to deal with. So I still stand by that, and I do believe that. Like I said, I believe, personally, this is just Tasha, I believe that Fantasia is called to use her gifts and talents for God and for God alone. You know, she can do the R&B thing, you know. I don't know if you heard me say it, if you're watching my videos, you know I've said there's a difference, you know, between being called to do something and, you know, just choosing to use your gifts and talents. Fantasia was called to do, you know, to do that. I really do. Because there's just something about her when she performs, you know, gospel music, or when she's ministering in song to crowds or whatnot. There's something different about her. And, you know, and then there's other artists who do the same thing. There's something different about them too. But I'm saying there's something different with her. Like, I don't see it when I see Jennifer Hudson doing gospel music or something like that. You know what I'm saying? Like Fantasia and Ledisi, there's something different about them. One thing, because they only give us 30 minutes of this show, I really wanted an hour. They really should have did. At least just this one episode should have been an hour. But Fantasia didn't get to talk about her nurse. Now, we saw when she went on Good Morning America, and in her Behind the Music, she talked about her nurse. But I wanted them to put that back out in the atmosphere again, because to me, that was an angel. You know, even though she's been there, she's been working and whatnot, but to me, she Miss Melody, is either Melanie or Melody, whatever her name is, she was right there. That was her appointed time. You know, God used her. That was her point in time. So I think that's really awesome. You have to give glory to God doing this. And you guys, I'm sorry that I'm doing a whole... Well, no, I'm not sorry. Okay, y'all know me. Okay, God is good. And I just really thank him for putting people in Fantasia's path at this time. You know, I thank God for Aunt Bunny being there. I thank God for Brian being there. You know, it's just, you can just see it all on his face. I know I've said that, and the reason why I say Brian needs help is because you can just see it on him. He is so stressed out and bogged down. He has to deal with everything that comes Fantasia's way, and I just want somebody else to be there for him, basically, so that he can, you know, take a load off and be like, whew, let me calm down a little bit, you know, so he won't get pushed to the point of, you know, wanting to give up and stuff like that. But, you know, I just really thank God for, he still has his hand on it, his grace and his mercy. That's what it is. Because even when we step out of the will of God, you know, God never turns his back on us. And a lot of people say, oh, I found Jesus. Jesus is not lost. We're the ones who are lost. You know what I'm saying? Jesus didn't go nowhere. God ain't going nowhere. God never even turned around. It was us. You know, we stepped away. We turned our backs. And if we just turn back around, we would see that they're still there. Anyway, that's my little sermon for right now. But wait, yeah. Yo, it was a really good episode. It really was. It's the most realest reality TV episode I've ever seen in reality TV show history. You know what I'm saying? It didn't seem to me like anything was scripted. You know, it was just, you know, okay, we're going to give Fantasia her time to talk about what she needs to talk about. And, you know, and then we'll try to piece the show together as much as we can, you know, without going too deep into her personal life. But, you know, Fantasia's just that type of person. She'll share with you. You know, she ain't got nothing to hide. You know, thank God for his grace and his mercy, you know. So we just thanking God for grace and mercy. Thanking him that Fantasia is still here. I didn't realize how serious the suicide attempt was, because when we heard it, you know, we were like, aspirin? How you OD on aspirin and have to go to the hospital? But, you know, her kidneys were at the point of getting ready to start failing. So it was serious. It was serious. So just thank God for everybody who was there in her life and everything. So, yeah. Okay. So you guys. That's it for my review. I'll give you next week. We'll be back on, you know what I'm saying? This week was just it was a really emotional episode, you know what I'm saying? And so we just have to stop and pause and thank God for his grace and his mercy. Thank him for, you know, second chances. Thank God that, you know, he is always there. When we turn and walk away from God, he is still there just waiting for us to come back to him. So you guys, please keep Fantasia in prayer, keep her family in prayer. You guys also take this time to, you know, think about your life and everything too. Thank God for your family, your friends, and those who love you and support you. All right, this is your girl Tasha for Tasha TV. I'll see you guys in the next review. Remember, I love you, God loves you, and Jesus can save. All right, I'll see you guys next week.